then you don't need to work one day in your life. So I choose my love, my job, what I want, and I'm quite happy with that. So whenever I don't feel tripped, I don't feel like agitated or tension, busy, because I love my job. Because I work there, I teach the same thing. So whenever if there is a complex issue, maybe tomorrow some student is going to ask me. So I have to clear that. So that intention is there, that positive is there. So anything, maybe new thing come up. Now everything is about cloud technologies and all. So always I am into for learning all. So that time I am busy and I am making happy my office and also my students. So my wife, she works as a DPS teacher. I don't want a teacher like that. Jolly, it's a small children, you can play and they come by 3 o'clock and at least 3-4 months holidays. But that is not the case. At least teachers like her, more hard work. You know, every time she's creeping, oh man. And when it comes to politics, at least in my office, very minor politics and it's adjustable. But when coming to my school, politics are horrible. Every day, one story will come up. Kishore. That's it. It starts like that. The teacher, she took all my designs. I never allowed my name to come. Oh, really? And I'm a postmaster, right? I act. Oh. And I watch so much of body language. There is so much of gestures. And I wish you would have come to postmaster. Should have been much better. So I always keep creeping. Oh, my job is like that. My job is like that. So I want her to be more happy. Because I want her to live a more no-worry life. So then I thought, what can I do? So normally I go for Art of Living. And Art of Living is a place where, Guruji, Ravi Shankar, they conduct happiness program. And I'm a regular follower from past 6-7 years. And after attending that, I got a lot of peace. Because I was such a little free, moving guy and all. But, especially in IT, you cannot be successful every time. So there will be ups and downs, and compulsory you need spirituality. Okay, if you are not get addicted to spirituality, get automatically you get you will understand the greatness of spirituality and all. So then I attended happiness programs, a lot of programs I attended. Whenever I'm free, I just go there, I get a lot of peace of mind and all. And Art of Living is basically, I think a lot of people would have known. Anybody Art of Living follows yet? AOL follows? Okay. So Art of Living is based on like 5 principles. That 5 principles, if you follow right, your life will change. Just 5 principles. And I have gone through that, and today I am going to discuss about the 5 principles by which if you follow, you also will live a matata and no worry life, right? So the first principle what they say is, opposite values are complementary. What is it? See, life is ups and downs. Nobody is successful. You take Amitabh Bachchan, you take any person's life, there is no person who has lived a successful life. So life is up and down. So we need to be in balance. When it is success, you should not be get bored and, oh man, what is this? Be balanced. And when there is a failure, also you need to be balanced. So normally in my job also sometimes I get agitated there. Enough is enough. I work so much. I want to leave the job and go and resign the job and relax a lot. But recently I saw a woman called Oh Baby. There they say, what does a woman need from a man? I was eager, but what does he want? Oh, the man should be looking good. That's okay. Second point is, the man should be earning so much of money that she can buy so much of items. If I design a job, how can I buy her and how can I make my wife happy? So then again I started motivating and started working. So opposite values are complementary. If you understand the importance of happy only when you are sad, right? You will understand or you take anything, opposite values are complementary. So life will be up and down, but you need to be
balanced.
Take it easy. We cannot be completely successful, we cannot be completely brilliant. Just be balanced. So that is my first gateway. Okay, coming to business, Toastmasters is an international organization. Basically, improves your communication and
leadership
skills. Basically, in any agenda, we have 3 sessions. One is prepared speeches. People from pathways or traditional communication channel, they get prepared. They get prepared for a speech. The speech speech is given, this is a mentor, the member will write a speech, he will send to the his mentor and they will review and finally he will come and deliver here. So that is what is what? Prepared speeches. So next one is, you know, table topics, impromptu speak. So in table topics, what they are, you know, randomly they call on guy and give a random topic and he will talk 1 to 2 minutes. Okay, so that is called table topics, which is impromptu speaking. Last but not the least, we need evaluation, right? We need evaluation. So how did we do good? What are the recommendations? Where did we go on bad and what good? So the top recommendations are done by an evaluation session. So totally how many clubs we have around 3-4 lakhs members we have. We have 14,000 clubs spread across 130 countries worldwide. And it's a 90 years old. I think it is quite successfully balanced. So we have 200 plus clubs. So we have clubs at club level. Above club is the area level. Above area we have the division level. And above division we have the district. And in this we are belong to district 92. District 92. Like that, there are so many districts worldwide. And every year there will be one world champion who will be coming out. Who know who is the winner this time?
Never.
He was the world champion across so many districts. He won the world title. And you know, guess what? Guess what his speech? It was about a very, very simple marriage occasion which happened in India. And he wore a kurta pajama, a guy from Pennsylvania, and he delivered and he could win a speech. Okay? So let's talk about the general evaluator. Today the general evaluator is Toastmaster
Abhinav.
So let us invite Toastmaster Abhinav. Abhinav is our past president, very into very handsome guy, bachelor here, and a nobody guy. So let me invite Toastmaster Abhinav.
Was
Mama Bear. Mama Bear's speech was neat and very short, and she finished even before the timer would show the 45 times green card. The third speaker was? Yes, the baby bear. The baby bear finished his speech perfectly. He crossed the qualifying time, and while the timer was showing the target time, he tried to finish his speech, and before he could see the red card, he had concluded his speech. So guess whom they voted out scored for when it was voting? None of the above, because there were only three speakers. One was disqualified for word time, one was disqualified for other time, and there was only one speaker, so the essay thought, let's not put it on the voting list. And I'll be keeping the tab of everybody's tab, the tab every speaker takes on stage, and I'll be presenting my report at the end of the word time.
Toastmaster Gopi, who is taking this role to explain more about it. Toastmaster Gopi.
especially this happens in our office environments. We don't accept that guy. First of all, if rejection comes, that's it. We start rejecting them. And even a situation, something happens to our life, first we need to accept. Once you accept, almost 90% of the problem you can clear. But when you reject, then the problem comes. So you know, suppose you are going on a road, so there is some drunken person who is trying to fight with you. What are you going to do? There is no use talking with the guy. Just accept that person is drunken, there is no use. So let us better. Just let me get away from that place. So if you follow this, accept the people, not only people, and situations. Some good situations, some bad situations, just accept it. Then your brain will start working so well and you get a very good formula for that and you can clear, you can get away from that. Okay. So that is the second one. At the end of the session, I'm going to ask all the five. Okay? Okay. So today we have two speakers are there. One is Abhijit and we also have Mahavir. And Abhijit, I don't have an introduction about him, so in the form of Toastmasters, Abhijit doesn't need an introduction at all. He's already an excellent speaker, so let me introduce Abhijit. He is going to deliver icebreaker.